I'm Jitish Kallat. I'm an artist, primarily based out of Mumbai. You know, with my own work, it's often, I sometimes feel it's purely about making connections. I think I see myself over durations of time connecting two unrelated notes. Sometimes it could be two seemingly unrelated dates. It could be two individuals who shared a correspondence, and this could be a moment in history. It could be counting up astral forms in the sky. And sometimes I see myself constantly kind of drawing links that don't seem apparent to me initially. And it's often within the piece of work that that these connections get formed. Yet another thing I see myself often doing is having this kind of experience where, you know, you look at something and it becomes something else somewhere in the middle of your eye. And so a roti becomes a moon, or a letter becomes a film of fog, or a transcription of a speech become illuminated lights on the sort of risers of steps. And each of them then take me in directions and take me to themes that that often sometimes in durations of 4 or 5 years seem to reincarnate in a new form. So when I think of, say, Public Notice, it's probably 10 years of work that form three works, each sort of separated by 3 or 4 years. Or in a piece such as Artist Making Local Call, where the duration that I am at a phone booth making a phone call becomes also a still image with about a minute and a half of time. So collisions occur on the street, people pass away, but their shadows remain. And all kinds of themes that otherwise continue to engage me become part of a work purely by the panning of a camera and letting life play against the grain of the movement of the camera. So I often see myself just sometimes just wandering through through unrelated things, waiting for them to kind of make sense. The first Kochi-Muziris Biennale, which had so many different facets of it, which in a way we were seeing for the first time in this region, in a way imagined, conceived, and executed by artists, and in a way close to where daily life intersects closely with art, was in fact unlike several other projects we see in several parts of the world, where sometimes it's the state, the intention comes from a kind of top-down mapping of what might be imagined as deficiencies within a cultural system, and is often fulfilled by a state through acts of institution making or through planning a festival or an occasion, which actually comes from the imagination of the state. But what we really saw here was actually something that emerges from studios and becomes an environment where, with the flexible format of the Biennale, with open to public life in general, we saw an intermingling of vast numbers of people. And in a sense, we saw contemporary art really thrive, ground up within an active space of civil society. The other aspect was really what happened within the art itself. I think much of the work almost was experientially drawing yourself back to rethink the location where you were at that given point in time, and often energized and activated spaces, hidden histories, and the dense history which is also visible as the present in several parts of Fort Cochin, where the past continues to stay alive. And I think the Biennale in some ways became pointers to this dense and layered history of Fort Cochin. One of the really interesting things, and partly I think while watching the very first edition, I was not just looking at the art, but I was also looking at the audience, because it was a very invested way of viewing, of spending time with artworks that sometimes demand, you know, 25 minutes of viewing time. And it was interesting that audiences would commit time to art, which is progressively in short supply in the art world. And I think one of the worries that I've always had is that the bigger the projects, the less attention you have for the finer details and nuances. But a lot of experiences of actually viewing other viewers along with me makes me think that here is a place where a lot of real dialogue is possible.